Fuel prices have been hiked once again, burning a hole in the consumer's pocket. Now, according to the latest hike, this is the 23rd hike, by the way, which has taken place since the month of May. And this is also the sixth hike which has taken place this month. Petrol prices continue to remain above rupees 100 per litre in several cities. This includes in Mumbai, Jaipur, as well as in Bhopal. Petrol prices in other cities like Delhi, Kolkata and Chennai remain above the 95 rupees per litre mark. In fact, Congress is holding a nationwide protest against the hike today. So this is, of course, as we mentioned, yet another hike in petrol and diesel prices, the 23rd hike since the 4th of May. Every day we are seeing a hike by around 27, 25 paise per litre. Even today, that's the same trend that we are seeing in several cities across the country, where petrol has, in fact, been increased by roughly around 27 paise per litre. Diesel increased at a rate of around 28 to 30 paise per litre, roughly in most cities. And this is the 23rd hike, as we said, since May, and sixth hike, which has taken place in petrol prices this month itself. I'm joined by Mr. Ajay Bansal, who is a member of the All India Diesel Association, who's joining us over the phone line right now. Mr. Bansal, thank you so much for joining us. What we are looking at the moment, of course, is that there are a number of factors which are leading to the hike in fuel prices, petrol as well as in diesel. But this has, of course, also led to a lot of grief for consumers. Of course, till a few days back, we were in lockdown mode in several states. But now states are opening up, which means there will be more vehicles on the streets. And this is causing a lot of inconvenience to consumers as well.
Yeah, see, you tell that understand that there is so many factor of increase of our petrol price. But as far as India is concerned, we have one big factor is the taxation. Taxation part is too high. That is why the international crude price and the tax are the main impact, main reason of this price hike. Because the now APM, administrative price mechanism, we go by an international crude price, daily price mechanism, where every day there is a division in the prices. Now, the crude is on a higher side, going up. And that is the reason that every day the price is going up. So, it is, you say, it is not the time where the crude goes up. If you say historically, the May-June period is least or low crude price time. But now I don't know whether it's COVID or something. I don't know the reason this hike is unexpected. So basically, the crude goes up in the winter season.
So you are saying, Mr. Bansal, that usually...
Mm-hmm. Hello.
Right. So you are saying, Mr. Bansal, that usually you don't see this sort of a hike in the month of May or June.
Yes. So it's unexpected, and I don't know what is the reason. Reason is basically a COVID, and I think the Gulf countries or supply or something. Otherwise, we saw that the demand of the crude comes down in summer season because the European and all old countries buy crude for their their boilers to get a heat for their heating system. So historically see that this is the lean period for the crude prices, and winter in December or January, February, we see the hike. But I don't know, it's not good for our country and economy and
right.
For the public that this hike is at this time. As far as the dealers are concerned, we are also worried and having big losses due to the high coin prices, because every day our capital is increasing, we are getting a fixed margin, we are not getting
right.
any benefit of any price hike. We are getting a fixed margin, not on a percentage, but a fixed margin. And whenever there is a hike, our evaporation cost, like earlier the price of petrol and diesel was 80 or let's say 70 rupees, our evaporation cost was at the rate of 80 or 70. Now evaporation,
right.
Now it's 100 plus, so we are losing money. So and this is very very unfortunate that dealers and the public both are under very very big loss due to this price hike. And we only
right.
see one solution is that it has to come under GST on a one nation, one rate policy. So what we have demanded
there's
a long demand of that we should be bring back to the GST. It should come under the GST regime, GST net, so that the prices at least on a part of
right, Mr. Bansal.
Taxation can be come down. Yeah, this price
right, Mr.
Can
Bansal.
Be come
thank
down
you so much for joining us on the broadcast on this issue.